Welcome to the Marketers Control Room. It's all about IPL musings. IPL, that one property, that one cricketing league, that one tournament. That's much more than just a tournament. And we've got a fantastic panel to talk us through what's happening right now in 2020. And I'm sure all of us will agree about one thing, that IPL isn't just about cricket. It's about entertainment. It's about a mini economy in itself that kind of galvanizes a whole lot of other things, apart from players' careers who play in it, to finding people with a common thread of interest, excitement, whether it's the owner of a team, a multi-billionaire, or the average stall owner on the side of the road next to the stadium. They're all equally involved in the proceedings of what happens in the sport. It's also, I think, a thing that unites. We've got a certain MSD capturing a CSK team and being treated like a god, or a Ravichandran Ashwin from Chennai captaining a Delhi Capitals and, you know, being accepted by the fraternity. And most importantly, it's just revolutionized how sports run, sports leagues are run in the country. But I'll talk about the ROI that it generates for the stakeholders. And that's, I think that's going to be the starting point of where we're going. Because it's been a path break, and I think I'll get Mohit to start on this. It's been a pathbreaker of a league. It's shown other sports in the country how a league can be run. And of course, it's reinforced BCCI's position as the richest cricket board in the world. I'll leave it to you. Mohit, what's your thought on that?
Absolutely. So I think, as you rightly said, it's not a sport, it's an economy in itself. And, we actually look forward to this event every year. And the marketing calendars of our clients, and practically all our clients, are made keeping IPL in mind. So it's become like a part and parcel of your annual review. And this year, given the pandemic, everything had been planned at the start of the year with IPL in mind, but pandemic just decided to raise its ugly head at the start of the year, and everything went berserk. So I completely agree with you that it is something that we look forward to. It's an economy in itself. It's an ecosystem that has been built very, very, I would say, from one strand to the other over a period of time. And it's become a very key property for all stakeholders, whether it is we as agencies, as clients, as partners. Everybody looks forward to it, not just from an entertainment perspective, but from a business generation perspective. So, and that's why it is very, very important for all of us, for our livelihoods, as whatever, whatever we are representing here as.
Absolutely. It impacts livelihoods. As you said, it's impacting the livelihoods of players, of people involved in organizing the tournament. Of course, as I said, there are multiple elements involved, but the return of live sport, and I'm going to get Nikhil involved in this because, as a player who's been sitting on the sideline, I'm just wanting your mindset, because you've been a, former player yourself, played for the country. What's the mindset like? You've been out of action for almost 6 to 7 months, and suddenly you're coming back and playing a tournament like the IPL. It's just getting live sport back into the scheme of things.
Well, without a doubt, it's, you haven't been into action for 6-7 months. You're just raring to go. With the quarantine, everything you, as a mindset, you're about to deal with, you can deal with, because you see the light at the end of the tunnel. If you're in a bio bubble, your protocols have been given, SOPs, every player is ready to follow that, because at the end of the day, you're about to play. You've been away from the game for 6-7 months. The start date is going to be 19th of September. First game is going to go on. You might not have practiced, you're doing your training in your room, everything, but somewhere in your heart of hearts, in your subconscious minds, you're switched on for that game, because that's what you want to go out there and play and showcase your talent, win games. And the beauty is, you get to play. But this time, Raman is going to be a challenge, and I'll tell you why it's going to be a challenge. When you're so used to, for the match winners, playing in front of 60, 70,000 people, the match winners, Virat Kohli, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, the big names, they feed off that enthusiasm and that ambiance. Each time you hit a 4 or 6, the crowd goes nuts. This time around, you hit a 4 or 6, you know you've done a good job, but there's no reassurance coming from 60,000-70,000 people sitting. So, you know, it's like you're playing Ranji Trophy again in an empty stand. So this time is going to be interesting.
Absolutely. And you know, I think it's about going back to the roots for a lot of players. Because Ranji Trophy cricket, as you draw the right parallel, Nikhil, when we're covering Ranji Trophy cricket, there are barely, you know, 1,000 people, including the security personnel and the support staff in the stadium for some games.
But still, somewhere you've got the motivation to go out there and play because the pure love of the game. And I personally feel ever since the evolution of IPL or the start of the IPL, why our youngsters have been world-beating stars so quickly? Because you put an under-19 kid in an IPL team with 60,000-70,000 people, he goes out there, for instance, you know, Rishabh Pant wins games, get accolades from everywhere. Now when he wears the India colours, that fear is gone. The fear of playing in front of 60,000-70,000 people, that's gone. You're like, well, ultimately, it's just a battle between the bat and ball. Somewhere you start getting that belief system that I can go out there and do that. You know, there are no more butterflies in your stomach when you go and play for India because you're so used to playing, you know, in front of 60,000 people in the IPL. And of course, as a youngster, you're getting to rub shoulders in the same dressing rooms with some of the stalwarts from around the world, you know, role models. Now you're rubbing shoulders, spending time understanding their mindset. It's a, you know, no-brainer. You're going to be world-beating sports people.
Absolutely right. I mean, so many you know, young players from the country have actually used IPL as the stepping stone to play for India, don India colours. In fact, a lot of international cricketers put in a strong performance in the IPL and forced their boards to take a look at what they've done and play them in the limited overs format or the T20 format. You know, classic example, Sam Curran's of the world, they've got their chances there. So yeah, it's not just Indian players who've done that. It's you know, world players around the world who have the advantage. I'm going to get Komal involved in, you know, Komal, tell me something. From a brand's perspective, live sport is back. You know, there's of course been, you know, the Premiership that took the lead and you had football action in India beamed around the world. You've had the NBA looking at the restart. You've had IPL now, you know, the biggest of them all as far as India is concerned, kickstarting. So the chain reaction of live sports being triggered, how does a brand view it?
It's a beautiful opportunity because I think the country is starving for cricket, and especially India, you know how much we love cricket. We are mad about cricket. So 5 months of no cricket and fans are waiting to watch something live, something new, fresh. And like I said, despite having seen football or even for that matter, England, West Indies, you just feel like watching your Indian players coming back and playing. You know, you're missing Virat, you're missing Rohit, Bumrah. So this is what people are waiting for. And as a brand, I mean, we see this as a great opportunity coming before the festive season for a consumer durable. Nothing like it. It works well. Definitely, it is tough times for the brands also. But having said that, we have to make the most by utilizing it in a best possible way. And also be empathetic, like I said, because as a brand, we really, as Usha, we really believe in play as our ethos and we support inclusiveness, differently abled people. So coming back to life and life is amazing, as in we are waiting for it and excited about it.
Super. I'm gonna get Ankur involved in this because Ankur, you know, you've been spectacular as far as, you know, the on-ground execution of a whole lot of events is concerned. You're a part of the brand services that, you know, that your company Vibhyo offers. Offshore tournament, of course, it's live sport, it's live cricket, it's going to be beamed in India but played in the UAE. So how does that affect the ecosystem for in your eyes?
See, like Komal said, that we are a cricket crazy country and audiences have been starved for the last 6 months. So it doesn't matter where it's played. You see, like you said in the beginning, this is such a large ecosystem and there are multiple ecosystems in it. You know, fine, there was one physical ecosystem which is about the stalls and the stands and the audiences and the F&B and everything around it. But there are so many brands that do campaigns, on-ground campaigns, on-air campaigns, print campaigns around it, that today the physical location of the game really doesn't matter. Like Nikhil said, of course the players would miss the adrenaline rush, but the brands won't miss the adrenaline rush because of technology, because of multiple mediums, I believe all the campaigns that we keep done around it would still be done irrespective of where it's physically executed.
That's an interesting part. Location gets taken out of it because it's being beamed right into your house, and there are multiple media where the brand can create their presence. I want to get Vinita involved in this scenario, because the moment you're talking about that, making the brand's presence felt across different mediums, we've seen during the COVID times, more than the traditional media, it's the digital media penetration that has changed the landscape completely. So do you see a different approach adopted by brands going into this year's IPL?
Yeah, that's an interesting question, actually. That's the top conversations we're having with most of our clients, because what's happening is that, like you rightly said, while COVID has had the huge spurt of digitization, which has broken out, but the recent Bach report on smartphone usage did tell us that it's back to the original levels, probably slightly lesser to pre-COVID, the smartphone usage first. Secondly, Hotstar, as you may know, is no longer doing a tie-up with the telecom this year. So the Jio numbers that were there, that were huge numbers, are not there this year. So while at the generic medium level, we're all very excited about digital, and people do like to watch it on Hotstar, but it's a paid piece, and if it's not got a telecom thing and it's got only the 5 minutes free, we're not very bullish on Hotstar this year. Also, given that the pricing is not really very great in terms of, reducing it accordingly, because they are convinced that they are going to get the numbers on Hotstar somehow to be as close as original. But we're very bullish on television for sure.
Just in the defense of the broadcaster, the only thing that I'll say is, when you're dishing out close to about something like 3,300 crores a year in terms of just the sponsorship money that's going out for the IPL, yeah, you'd want to recover it from somewhere. And that's an interesting point, and I'll get I'll get your thoughts on this. Everyone's talking about a great opportunity. The IPL is presenting a great opportunity to brands to showcase themselves on the biggest cricketing league in the world, on that platform. But yet we're seeing changes happening in the sponsorship structure that the BCCI itself had for the tournament. Mohit, your thoughts on that? You had Dream 11 come in as the title sponsor, Bieber pulling out, and almost half the value.
That's right. Yeah, I mean, Vivo's pulling out was unprecedented again, and this is a year of unprecedented things happening. And it is a challenging year for all of us. We know that, right? We were not even sure whether we'll have IPL, honestly. At some point in time, all marketeers had come to a situation when we restarted in June and we went to our clients. We did not know whether IPL is happening. While there was a spark that it will happen, it might happen, but we were not sure. And there were already, alternate plans that were being created because, life was going on. But then when the news of IPL happening happened, then all plans had to be reoriented. So given that, the very fact that you do not have as much budgets as you had last year to put on that particular event, right? And that definitely has impacted the extent of sponsorship that IPL is and BCCI is generating this year, because finally it's the finite money or the marketing monies that are existing across all portfolio of companies. So that is bound to happen, and I'm happy that in spite of all this, we still have sponsors both on the along with BCCI as well as on the on-air front, and I am very happy to see that a lot of clients, including a lot of my own clients, have shown a lot of interest towards buying the property, if not as a sponsor, but as a regular presence partner. So you're right, and this is something that was expected. I was expecting it that when IPL, if at all it happens finally this year, there will be compromises that will be made on the sponsorship front, and we will not be able to rake the kind of monies, the partners will not be able to rake the kind of monies they did last year, because it's a very special year. But in spite of that, of it being a special year, and with all the handicaps that we've had, I'm happy the way it has progressed till now. I'll put it that way.
That's That's an interesting thought. Yes, you know, we're all happy, like cricket's happening at least, and brands are getting that same platform to showcase, you know, their wares with a property that is very well known. But I'll go back and talk about that the money angle a little more, because I think when you're looking at a successful league around the world, the major contributor to revenues, the central pool, and I won't talk about the you know, the pool for each team. The main contributor to the central revenue pool is always the broadcaster. Whether you look at the NBA, or, you know, any rich league, successful league around the world, it's the broadcaster, you know, underwriting money, which is the driving force of this. There might have been, and I'll get Vinita involved in this. Vinita, there might have been reductions in sponsorships, title sponsor, associate sponsor, and you know, so on and so forth. But the broadcaster fee is still coming through, which is probably making this entire project viable.
Oh, absolutely. I think, and Star is, you know, doing a good job, I'd say, to selling it well as of now. Like Mohit said, we're happy that there are takers, because the first thing that came to us was, oh my God, how are we going to sell such a high costed, how rate, it's a very high rate, very high investment. Having said that, it's got stature, it's got leadership, brands want to associate with it. So if you have got the money, nobody will miss out the opportunity. It's just about, because the pandemic times are there, because it's a double whammy, because it's festive time and first time IPL coming during festive, usually it's during summer. And with a lot of work from home still being on, certainly media viewership is on the high. So we are very bullish on the television aspect of the broadcaster viewership, like I said. So yeah, it's going well. I think they've got, as of now, I don't know the exact number, but I think got Mohit, 10 plus sponsors already are there.
Yeah, absolutely. So
yeah, they've got
3 co-presenting and yeah. 7 associates and, oh yeah, easily.
Yeah, so I think in
answer, and at least there are 2-3 more associates being closed by Tuesday.
Yes. Only thing we may be seeing is how many number of advertisers and brands. So the last year, and I think over the years, IPL has increased the bandwidth of the number of advertisers. I'm not too sure that's going to happen this year, because a lot of our medium and smaller advertisers are rethinking, because they may not find it viable. Like I said, they would love to, but their monies don't, you know, like permit participating in it.
Nikhil, as a, you know, as someone who's played the game, I'll get your thoughts on this. There's only a limited number of places where you can still, you know, carry the brand logo of the brand that's associated with your franchise, and a couple of key areas already sold on the, you know, jersey with the central pool. The team has only limited slots that they can offer to their sponsors.
Well, true. I know a couple of teams, you know, they had some issues as well. Their main sponsor had pulled out, but very quickly they were able to, you know, sell that space, you know, the front of the shirt. Like I think Vinita ma'am and Komal ma'am said, that this time around, because the IPL is during the festive season, and the entire country or the entire world, because IPL being such a big spectacle, is just waiting for it to start. You know, somewhere it's not just about the sport, Raman, and I might be wrong, but I'm looking at it from this perspective, where people want to see live sport to the magnitude of the world's, one of the world's most popular leagues, to say, yeah, shaam ko baith ke, you know, I want to say that there's some sort of normalcy happening somewhere in the world. Somebody sitting in the States, somebody sitting in England, watching IPL, and you know, somehow it just takes away the pain, or you just want to simply enjoy that sport for 3 hours, and whatever's happened in the past, you want to forget that. So I'm looking at it from that perspective as well, that people are eagerly waiting for the IPL to start, just to, you know, we've been hearing so much of COVID, you know, the social distancing, you know, the SOPs, what you need to do, washing hands, things like that. It's like you want to be in your own house, and just not, if you want to switch on TV, you want some sort of good news coming out as well, because it's unfortunate what's happened, it's unprecedented time, but there is a ray of hope when you see the IPL and live action happening as well.
Absolutely.
That's almost, I'd say it's almost like media's way of signaling revival of economy.
Absolutely.
Well, as they say, being the beacon of hope.
Yes.
Just not to sport. And Komal,
I would just like to add what exactly Nikhil was saying. It's like we are looking for an opportunity from gloom, doom to bloom. That's one thing which will happen with this. And also, what regarding brands, we're seeing that, you know, we were not expecting those many brands to come back, and not talking from just Usha perspective, but otherwise also, you see there's a switch because of new normalcy. There's a lot of digital brands which have come up, and there's a lot of FMCG who benefited because we started hoarding initially. So there is a switch, there's a transition we'll see, and we'll see some of the FMCG brands coming, or consumer durable brands which are focusing on coming to, you know, IPL just before festive season, because they have those marketing budget which they spend, but there's nothing fresh and new. And like Nikhil said, you know, you're listening about COVID all the time. I think you want to have that relaxed time watching cricket, having fun, feeling good about it, and hoping the normalcy to come back with some new ones too. So yeah, I think that's what.